Everybody.
Hello.
Hello, hello, and again, hello. Welcome back to The Hot Spot, where we ask all the hard-hitting questions, whether if you want to hear the answers or not. And today, we are joined by the fabulous Madulika. I wanna properly pronounce your last name. Madulika is crushing Nan. All right, that's your last name to me.
If you need me to say it one more time, it's Madulika. I am an actress in LA with him. We're crushing it. I'm from the Bay Area, born and raised. I have a lot of Bay Area pride. I love all of our sports teams. I'm not going to get too much into that because that could be a whole other interview for 6 hours. I do like to rep them, go Dubs right now.
Okay.
I live in Santa Monica by the beach.
Absolutely love it.
It's my little own oasis in LA. Yeah. Like to like get away from. No, not him, but
to get away from him. I live here just to get away from you.
It's just relaxing out there and peaceful, and the ocean is just a wonder.
Okay. I've always kind of been curious about California in general. I just moved out to Chicago to Cali. But as I understand from my modestly small research. You grew up on Northern California and moved to USC.
Yes. I came down for college.
Mm-hmm.
I went to USC undergrad. We'll keep the years ambiguous, you know.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, don't worry about when we were in college.
Definitely 18.
Yeah, I came down to USC, and I've kind of been here ever since because the industry, you know, gotta be out here. Yeah. I do want to eventually move to New York at some point. I think the work brings me there. Right now, I feel like there's a lot of work out here that I'm like, don't want to give up yet. So.
That's very fair. I'm curious, who were your idols when you kind of came up into this business, and it could be something that was like before you really went into acting, or even now, like who are some of the idols that you look up to?
I always go to this. I've been asked this question a lot. Kristen Wiig. I don't know what it is.
Okay.
Dry. I think I really related to her dryness and her sarcasm.
Okay. That's my favorite.
Affected me, especially entering the kind of film TV. Even though she's really theatrical and charactery SNL, like you've said, she's
brilliant, yeah.
In every way, shape, and form. I did Groundlings too because of her. And Melissa McCarthy. I was like, all right, these actresses a lot. This is probably where I would, out of the three improv schools.
Do you find yourself catering more to like comedy and satiricals, or as compared to like dramatic and like realism, or like? Like, which do you see yourself catering for?
For the longest time, it definitely was comedy. And like my agents too, and like everyone who reps me, they're like comedy. Like they all, like that's just they know me as, because they also like the work that they've seen me do too. I mean, I definitely would say comedy is the strength of my focus, but over the past few years, I've kind of like taken myself out of that. I do have a really dark, dramatic side, I believe, especially in theater, that I would explore a lot. And so I can't say one way or the other anymore. I'm very open to both, depending on the story and the role. anyone that I remotely resonate with. I feel like I can go either direction.
You know, again, from the modest research that I've done, mm-hmm. I know that you were part of a multiple, of course, online projects, Darman, as well as being, why am I blanking on her name? Oh, from Aladdin,
Jasmine.
Yes.
Yeah, that was the highlight.
Yes, Jasmine, on Totally TV. One thing that I was noticing across, you know, multiple interviews that you've done, as well as just roles that you've done across platforms, that you get cast a lot as the, you know, sassy, mean, you know, or ultimately just somebody who has like a very cold type of attitude.
Yeah.
Is that something that you hate, or is that something that you actually have embraced?
No, I think I've put that upon my, I think that happened because I manifested that kind of in a way.
Okay,
I did.
Okay.
My one of these, the roles that I played in college was theater. We did a year of Chekhov. I don't know if any of you are.
Yes, Anton Chekhov.
Theater
yeah.
People will totally know what that is. And I played Natasha and the Three Sisters. Like,
which
initially, like, everyone's getting cast. Because I remember when we were casting this at the beginning of the year, and like everyone was like, okay, we're all gonna be one of the sisters. Like, she just wasn't in people's minds. And then one of our teachers was like, you're Natasha.
Yeah.
I was like, oh. And then, but I mean, that was probably like one of the highlights of my college experiences, like just exploring dimensionality within villain characters and how they're not just, it's not black and white as much as you want to, like, as a viewer and as the audience, you want to like label the character, like, you know, everyone has, people are the way they are because of maybe a deeper insecurity or like, so it was incredible exploring that. That's always kind of like motivated me to play villains and play character or any kind of character that you wouldn't expect, or you wouldn't expect to have a kind of backstory or a kind, like, whole other perspective that you could then bring out in the character. But so I feel like I've always kind of leaned towards that. I did play in another play that I did in college. I was like, mean, I don't know. I guess I'm a very loud, sassy person in general. So I think Jasmine, I really enjoyed just bringing a little bit of, there was a little more room with the parody that we were doing with Disney, where each of the princesses that were all played by these amazing girls that I worked with, some of them also wrote the scripts and were so funny and so relevant and modern for kids. Like, one example is just, I remember this is like one of my favorite episodes where Barbie picked us all up from school. We're all hanging out. Like, it's relatable content for kids.
Right.
And, Maleficent casts a spell on us and turns us into dolls because we didn't accept her follow request on Instagram.
Oh, like,
God. So funny. Like, so it was fun to like really bring personality into that. I think that's where I kind of got branded on YouTube as like sassy and like the way that I would deal with Jafar. Like, right. I was just very like, so that kind of personality carried over, I think, to the other roles that I played on YouTube, which were also like big and dramatic and sassy and mean.
Has the hustle for acting changed for you, you know, post-pandemic? More specifically, like, has the grind been a little more redefined for you as an actor navigating through online content versus like something that you know, something that is a little bit more traditional, such as TV or film? Has that grind changed for you, or is it all kind of the same?
I think even before the pandemic, we were heading in that direction of online content, and I mean, TikTok blew up in 2020, like insanely, but I think that was inevitable regardless of COVID or not. So I think my head was already kind of moving in that direction. And I'm always open. For me, it's really about the story that we're telling and the message. And so as long as that aligns with me, I don't really, the format is it's irrespective. I think I can adapt as an actress, like having done theater, having done film and TV, and like being able to be adaptable. I think I can adapt to kind of any medium as long as it's doing what fulfills me as an artist, which is telling a story that needs to be told or sending a message out there. So I've always kind of been open to it. I do think it's beneficial. I mean, the opportunities are just now more and more with the different
right
games. and it's also way less competitive online than it is like for the niche, for the film and TV kind of world. They don't want like necessarily the same actors and the same faces. It's like a little more like people from anywhere can kind of be a part of it, and people can like contribute to it and make their own content kind of thing. There's just more and more being done online, so there's just more and more opportunity for like any and every actor, which I love and endorse. The problem is, and this is kind of brings me back to the Darman thing and the situation, is it's not as regulated and people can get away with
a lot of things.
And so actors, you know, who want to work and who want to share their art and tell their stories can get exploited more easily, I think, in this open realm of the online world that we're still kind of trying to figure out how to regulate and how to, as we've done with film and TV, with unions, and still trying to figure that out. I think there's still a lot to like, and the demand, I mean, because there's just more and more coming, it's just so hard to keep up. Like that whole world is still being created, I guess. And what that space looks like the new media versus commercial versus social media versus, you know, so there's it's kind of very open-ended, which is a little risky. But I'm definitely open to the idea of like more reach and more work and more possibilities. That's like what drives storytelling. So
you speak so from the heart, and it's very authentic.
I can tell you really love this craft. And what you do.
And we're like, I know, I love it.
And
like, I love
you. You know, I love that. But you know what? That's why you are on the fireplace hotspot. It's in the spirit of our show. Y'all already know what comes next. We do not just like to sit around. We like to get moving. We like to have fun here. Okay. We gave y'all a lot of life lessons. Now it's time to make sure that you guys regret coming here. Amongst the masses, y'all know what Riz is, right? Some have put it in the definition of picking up girls.
It's literally just short for charisma.
Yeah. That's what I would consider to be. You know, so we're gonna do what's called Riz 101. Madhulika, you put off this aura of being cool, confident, charismatic, and almost to, you know, a deafening sense of purpose. I do the opposite.
There's a boss. He's like,
I did say that, didn't I? You're gonna teach me how to be as confident and courageous as possible, and teach me how to riz. I think there's different levels, of course, to Rizonomics, and I think the first and foremost method is the talk, right? What I want to have you do is you say a couple of phrases, some lines. It could be pickup lines, but it could even be just like, you know, regular words in general. I'm going to try to say the same thing. You're gonna have to approve if what I my interpretation of what you're doing is cool and has riz. First level being meeting meeting someone that you want to become friends with.
Yeah.
Let's just put it that way.
Just friends?
Just friends.
All right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. We'll start there.
Hey, man. What's up? How are you?
Hey, man. What's up? What?
No, nothing.
No, no. Come on. All right.
I think you could be a little more, like, try less.
Try less.
Yeah, I think you could just, you know, it's very casual.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, there's too much pep in your step to start with.
Like a casual kind of, you want to, you know, get real with someone.
Mm-hmm.
It's not put on or anything. It's just like you genuinely are like, what's up? Like, mm-hmm. how, like, you know, what are you up to? Like, I think you just need to make it known what you want and go after.
All right. Hey, man. What's up?
The hey man was there.
The hey man was a little closer. The okay. What's up?
The what's think, up?
Oh, to
I think it's not unless right. He's literally killing someone.
Oh, all right.
Not shocked.
Hey man, what's up?
Okay.
Yeah.
I think we got it.
Yeah. All right. Hey. All right. Okay. Now let's talk about picking up girls.
Oh, you are.
But
yeah. Even if you learn how to pick up, you know, guys,
we'll go that route. But I'm spoken for, and if anything, this would be more so to impress my girl.
So he's approaching me.
Yeah, or any girl. Like if he was approaching, you know, any girl.
Okay,
you like,
I'll that be the guy girl. Approaching the girl.
That's there you go. There we go.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I'll just do it and then explain it after.
Yeah.
I'm just sorry. I'm imagining you doing this.
I cannot wait to try it.
Okay. Hey. That's it.
Oh, that's it? All right. All right.
I don't even have to speak sometimes to get my. If you're good,
just
and you just look at me, it has to be the right look. Even one little look that's off, it's like a predator. All right. Like, ew.
Okay, so it's a look. Yeah, this thing is
the unspoken rules.
All about the look and all the about energy the look. And the
look confidence. And the energy and confidence. All right. Hey. What? I said, hey.
I think it's a little ironic.
Girl, I said, hey.
I think all right. It's a little ironic that you were very calm, and you know your energy was just that you degaff mm-hmm. kind of, but your hey was the opposite of everything.
Oh,
it
okay.
Was
like all right.
A, it was like a, hey.
All right, the proper theme.
Oh, you want some subtext?
Some subtext, yes.
The subtext is let me f*** you.
Oh, damn. All right.
Remember, you're kind of asking permission, but you're not. You're also...
Okay. All right.
You know what you want.
Yeah. Okay. Gotcha. I know what I want. Hey. Nah.
The most threatening thing I've ever heard.
I know what I want, though. It's hard to do this in one word. But, okay. All right. So,
I think it
needs to be... That's also an acting exercise, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
I think instead of trying to, like, put all of the intention in the word, just mm-hmm. put the intention in your body and let the word come out when it comes out.
Okay, gotcha. Intentions in the body. Say the word.
You're really seeing and visualizing this person.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I got it. Hey.
And
okay. I'm sorry. All right. For real this time. All right. Hey.
Yeah.
I like that.
Okay. What would be that next step that you would want to do to make someone understand, you know, I'm here to really strike up a conversation with you about something?
I think I would get really real with why, like, something brought you to this person. I'm assuming we're at a bar and she's having a drink and you noticed her and you went up to her to say, hey, why specifically her and why not anyone else in the room? That's probably what you would want to say to her in some context.
Okay.
I see you're drinking a double absinthe. That were me drinking a double absinthe or something. Why are you drinking that? I mean, you wouldn't say why you're going to eat, but you know what I mean? There's there's something that like brought you to this person.
Mm-hmm. Okay, something that brought me to this person. Okay. All
right. So what brought you to her? And
okay. I'm gonna try it. Okay. Hey. I like your nose. It's something about it, just it's kind of gross, but I like it.
Okay, so you're telling me someone with a gross nose is
that's going to attract you to them?
Well, something that could be perceived as like universally gross, but like it's like unique to me is like,
You might want to mention that.
Yeah, maybe like
you just
not
called her nose gross. And
well, maybe not gross is the right word. Thing.
Maybe all right. Focusing on the latter half of that, ladder. Where you said it's special to you.
Okay, your nose looks special.
I wouldn't.
Maybe not that really either.
Yeah, if you want to compliment someone, compliment them on something that they've done to themselves, okay. Not something they were born with.
Agreed.
Okay, all right. So, like, I like that you showered today.
How do you know?
Or you smell nice. That's
you
a
smell
rewording.
Nice. Okay. Okay.
You know, I would even just kind of not talk about her body.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah,
that as well.
Like something that's a little bit more like about
something they've done, the hair, clothes.
Okay.
Their choice of drink.
Okay. I see that you've ordered a drink. I don't drink. You know,
but you like the way that she's drinking it, which brought you over.
I like the way that she's drinking it.
I don't know what it
I like the way
you I like how you're swallowing that.
What? I think you don't know in your mind what brought you to this woman. I think that's the point.
I'll give you guys a legitimate attempt. If I saw my partner across the bar, and this is gonna be legitimately me doing it. Okay. Not like a put off version of myself. Hi, I like your outfit. You know, you got little cats and stuff on there. My name's Greg. I love dancing, and I know, like, I don't know if you like dancing, but I like dancing, and I would absolutely love if I could dance with you. It's okay if you say no. I was gonna dance anyways, but if you want to meet me on the dance floor, cool. All right. See you later.
The one problem I have with that is you immediately counted yourself out. You're like, it's okay if you say no.
Okay.
And like,
I mean, but it is though.
Right, but it at the end of the day, it is. But you don't need to give her that option.
Right. She knows it's okay to say no. You don't need to tell anybody that.
Yeah. Also, everything I feel like was a question. Like, you were like, I like that you have cats on. Like, it's like, no, I love that you have cats. Like, I tell her how you feel. Don't ask her how you feel. Oh! Okay. Tell her how you feel and tell her what you love.
Okay.
And tell her she can or can't join you.
Okay. I'll take that note. Hey. I like that you have cats on your jacket. I'm going to go dancing. And I want you to dance with me. That just so weird to me. Like I'm like, who the hell am I to say I want you to dance with me?
Yeah, but who the hell are you to not? You gotta go in this world and in this life, you gotta go after what you want. It's not gonna come to you.
Yeah.
You can't just tell her like, come meet me, Kaylee.
Yeah, get your ass over here. Get your ass over here and dance with me. Thank you so much for helping us on our Riz adventure. You know what I'm saying? Claps all around. You know what I'm saying? So with that in mind, that honestly does it for us here today, everybody. Thank you so much, Madhulika, for being here. We really appreciate you being here. That being said, do you have first outro? Do you have any closing statements you want to make about
closing statements?
Anything you're working on or any advice you want
to
give?
One of the overall points that I like to end with too is I feel like, especially for like actors and aspiring actors, is as long as you are following your heart and doing the thing that you genuinely want to do, then you're on the right path.
Make sure to follow Madhulika on all our social media platforms, Instagram, TikTok, Twitter?
Yes.
Yeah.
I need to do that. All of us is like, Twitter.
You know, follow all the things. You know what I'm saying? It's all love over here. Thank you, Madhulika, again so much for being here. We really appreciate you.
Thank you, guys.